back to the Darkness Inside podcast. I'm super excited because today I am bringing you the first episode of this podcast. I want to thank everyone for supporting the trailer when I finally released it. In this podcast, I hope to bring you some true crime cases, missing people cases, unsolved crimes, and some paranormal cases as well. Just as a caution for some of you, some of these cases that I will be talking about will be a little grim, so I know some of you guys aren't into that kind of grim stuff or, yeah, just things like this. So I do want to give you guys a heads up. I really want to say that every case I will be talking about, I'm going to show my absolute respects to it. Because these are real cases. These are real people that have lost their lives or are still missing to this day. And they deserve the utmost respect. So with that, I'm excited to bring you guys the first episode. It is going to be a short episode just to see how this goes. But yeah, let's get to it. Today we're going to be talking about the murder of Cassie Stoddart. This murder is also known as the Scream Murder because the killers took inspiration from the Scream movie franchise. Cassie was born on December 21st, 1989, in Pocatello, Bannock County, Idaho. Her brother describes her as a typical teenage girl that loved drawing and music. She was just your average teenager. She was a straight-A student. She was murdered on September 22, 2006, which means she was only 16 years old when she was murdered by these two teenage boys that also happened to be her classmates. They all attended Pocatello High School. Tori Adamchik was born June 14, 1990, and Brian Draper was born on March 14, 1990. These two guys were so obsessed with slasher films and mass murderers that had happened in real life. They had written their own movie script and were starting to work on their own film. Kids just say they were always walking around school with a video recorder, just filming themselves all the time. And this would be a valuable piece of evidence later on in the case. Cassie Stoddart was murdered on September 22, 2006, making her, Tori, and Brian only 16 years old at the time of her murder. On that date, Cassie was house-sitting for her aunt and uncle who were away for the weekend. The house was in a remote location of Pocatello, Idaho, named Whispering Cliffs, which is just northeast of Baddock County. She was there to water the plants, take care of the pets, and just take care of the house. She did invite her boyfriend, Matt Beckham, that Friday night to keep her company. They had only been dating for a few months at the time of her death. It is said that they were only dating for like 5 months, I believe. On that night, they decided to invite Tori and Brian over to watch a movie. Although Tori and Brian, when they were being interrogated, said that they were there for a party. They both stayed for approximately 2 hours before they left, telling Cassie and her boyfriend that they were going to the local movie theater to watch a movie. While doing my research, I did read something about how before leaving, Brian did unlock the back door without Cassie knowing, so that later on in the night they could both come in. While Cassie and Matt were alone, the lights went out in the house, and this frightened Cassie. She wanted her boyfriend to stay with her because of this, but when he asked his mom for permission, she denied. She said no. It is believed that Matt did leave the house around 10:30-ish, but before he left, he called Brian or Tori to let them know that he wasn't staying. And I read somewhere while doing my research as well that they spoke in a hushed tone, like if they were at the movies. So when Brian left, this is when Tori and Brian came in and turned the lights off from the circuit breaker that was located in the basement. They were hoping that Cassie would go down there and try to figure out how to turn on the lights back on like they do in the movie. this is where they planned to attack her, in the basement. But when Cassie never came down, they just decided to go up into the house. They were dressed in dark clothes and wearing masks. Brian had a dagger-type knife, and Tori had a hunting-style type of knife. When they came out of the basement, that's when they both attacked Cassie, stabbing her a total of approximately 30 times, with 12 of those being fatal. Because of the tape that the police would later find, the killing of Cassie happened somewhere between 10:30 to 11:30 after brutally stabbing her to death. They just left her body there, which wouldn't be found until September 24, 2006. 2 days later from being stabbed to death, her little cousin was the one who found her body. The little cousin was only 13 years old. Tori Adamczyk and Brian Draper were arrested on September 27, 2006, 3 days after Cassie's body was found and 5 days after they had both killed her. They were both charged with first-degree murder and conspiracy to commit first-degree murder. When they did get arrested, they each blamed each other. They turned on each other, basically. But then later, Brian Draper would confess that he was inspired by the Columbine shooters, and Tori Adamczyk would be inspired by the Scream franchise films. It would be Adamczyk that would lead investigators to the Black Rock Canyon area, where they had buried the evidence. 16 items had been buried there, such as the knives, the clothes they wore, notebooks, and most importantly, the videotapes. In these videotapes, they can be seen planning to kill Cassie and maybe other people. And also, after killing Cassie, they recorded themselves talking about the crime they had just committed. They talked about stabbing her. They talked about how it had felt, how they had felt seeing her lifeless body there on the floor. You can still find these on YouTube, but just a caution, they are pretty grim. They both received life in prison and are both serving time at the Idaho State Correctional Institution. They received life without the possibility of parole and 30 years to life for being convicted of conspiracy to commit murder. They have appealed and continue to appeal after almost 14 years after the crime, but all appeals have been denied. It is really sad what happened to Cassie. She was so young and had a whole life ahead of her. And Tori and Brian wanted the infamy that came with other criminals, that they decided to take the life of someone that was their friend. Well, guys, let me know what you guys think about this case. This is all I have for this episode on Cassie Stoddart. Again, thank you for the support, and just let me know what you guys think. If you guys have any topics for suggestion, that is also welcomed. See you guys in the next episode, and remember, beware of the darkness inside.